Time for another jam session. Our friend Joe Minoso from Chicago Fire. He's hanging with the crew. We're going to chop it up here. Joe, you ready for it?
Let's do it, man. I'm a little nervous, but yeah, let's try it.
yeah, you're nervous. He's a TV star. All right, according to U.S. News & World Report, trials on a new male birth control pill are showing promising results. You're shaking your head. You like this one. Even if the pill is successful, would you trust your man to take it? Joe, could you be trusted to take this one?
I mean... No, because I can't be trusted to take any kind of pill. Like, and not because I'm just that guy. I constantly forget. Like, it's, you know, it's like you got to take the pill at a certain time with food, you know. So I don't know that I would. I think it's great, though. I think it's about time, quite honestly.
Yeah.
It makes perfect sense. But yes, don't trust that he will do it.
No shot.
Just leave it on the bed. I would.
What if, like,
a little reminder with a glass of water?
The weight of the repercussions if you don't take it it's so large.
Oh, that's true. It's on you now, homie.
That's what I'm saying. You control your destiny, right, Joe? That's what I'm thinking.
I guess when you really kind of think about the possible ramifications, then maybe we are more trustworthy.
All of a sudden, a man's mind gets a little bit sharper.
Yeah.
I can't do anything until I take this pill.
That's the one thing I can't forget, man.
Yeah. To, like, share the responsibility. That's good.
I would take.
No, I think it's great.
I would take four of them. A day, Joe, just to be safe. Just pop one. Middle of the day, you just forget, just in case.
Full vasectomy at this point, bro.
One of the funniest things I saw is that the symptoms they were talking about is like 6 to 8 pounds of a weight gain, a little bit of a headache, irritableness, and it's like, that's all women have been dealing with for years.
But that's not how life should work. Just because it's happened to y'all, should be like, they should feel our pain. That's not fair, is it?
Yes.
I feel as if this is something that I should not
I'm still the one that's carrying it for 9 months.
Joe, we need your wife
on here. Welcome to 6 to 8 a.m. Monday through Friday.
I see that now.
Now you see how it goes. All right, well. This weekend, funny man and comedian Hannibal Buress was performing at Loyola University Chicago when he opened up his act with jokes referencing child sex abuse allegations against the Catholic Church. His microphone was cut off. After taking a break, he was allowed to finish his set. Here's what a university spokesperson had to say about it all. Loyola University Chicago cut the mic on Hannibal Buress' performance Saturday, March 17th, because he violated the mutually agreed upon content restriction clause in his contract. Was Hannibal out of line for this?
I don't think so, man. I happen to kind of believe in free expression, especially for comedians. I actually heard that he posted, like, up on a big screen right before he started his act, like, all of the rules and regulations. And then he said, screw that, I'm not going to do it. And I kind of respect him for it. At the same time, you know, he signed a contract, but it's like, you can't expect Hannibal Buress to kind of censor himself. He's Hannibal Buress, you know, and I think it's part of what makes him unique and interesting.
Shouldn't they have known?
That's what another student said, that this is why you bring this person on set, because, like, you know, he's going to go and say ballistic things. At the same time, as you mentioned, he signed a contract, so you could have done that beforehand.
True.
Now you're taking these people money.
It's what he does. It's what the brother does. It's, you know, he wasn't doing anything harmful. I think he was just doing his act.
You got to know who he brought in. I mean, this is the guy that exposed Bill Cosby.
Yeah,
this guy that exposed Bill Cosby. That's kind of what his reputation is.
Yeah, exactly. Like, it's like, that's the guy you think you're going to censor, you know, in the middle of a college performance. These kids are going to see that stuff.
Also, I always love the line, if you can make them laugh, you can make them listen. And I think that's what Hannibal Buress' brand of comedy is. Is, like, he really sheds light on a lot of important issues.
Yeah.
Based on being funny.
There's a message with it.
So now I figured out why you guys never listen to me. I got to work on my content here, get you to laugh, so then you'll pay attention to me.
You have us laughing.
6 to 9 a.m., bro. You know, that's the problem, 6 to 9 a.m.
See, now I don't feel bad at you. Now I don't feel bad you messed up his name. It's 6 to 8 a.m.
Oh, no. Oh, my God. I just think this show was so good. It needs to be on an extra hour.
Joe Minoso.